seated this evening. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Tonight I want to speak on why do we believe on the words of the apostles. And if you realize the words that were given to them, I want to go now to the book of John chapter 17 and the very first verse. But you must understand something about the word that you are about to read and throughout the whole Bible. The author of the Bible.
I turned the piano off. Should I turn it back on? Okay. All right.
Hallelujah.
Fixed.
So I want to go now to the book of John chapter 17 and verse 1. Hallelujah. To explain to you why we believe completely in the teachings of the apostles. As you read through chapter 17, you will understand why. I'm going to explain it to you a little bit different. I'm going to explain it to you from the very essence of God, which is love and wisdom. Hallelujah. But love and wisdom also has many other subtitles or words that you may use. Hallelujah. So let's go to verse 1 of chapter 17. It says, these words spake Jesus and lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour is come, glorify thy Son, that thy Son also may be glorified with thee. Hallelujah. It talks about the glorification of the Son and the reason he was glorified. He came to bring redemption to a mankind, and there were many acts of his redemption. He said, the Son is whom God descended, when God descended into our world to bring redemption. And the Bible tells there was an exact time when this happened. Hallelujah. Galatians 4:4 tells you, at the exact time of the precise time, God sent forth his Son into the world under the law made of a woman. So God has his divine time, but it was God himself that descended into our world in the form of man in order to bring forth redemption. How powerful is that?
Amen.
Jesus is not another God.
No.
He's the Almighty God. The everlasting Father.
Amen.
He is everything.
He's everything.
Yeah. And these are things you must know and understand.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. He came at a certain time, but it was to bring the act of redemption unto us.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's go to verse 2. As thou hast given him power over all flesh, that he should give eternal life to as many of them as thou hast given him. Hallelujah. The only way he could give eternal life to anyone, because he was God himself, who came in human form. And that's all it means. Hallelujah. It does not mean another God gave it to him. It just means that he has the power to give eternal life because he was God himself in human form. Verse 3 said, and this is eternal life, that you might know that they might know thee, the only true God, even Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. All it means by the whom thou hast sent is the time that our God came into this world as a man to bring forth redemption. Is that understandable? There's not two gods, there are not three.
That's right.
God himself him came as a man and went through the acts that he went through to bring us redemption unto our lives. Hallelujah. Now I want to go to Jeremiah 9 and verse 24. It says, but let him that glorieth glory in this, that he understand and knoweth me. This is the Lord God speaking. That I am the Lord which exercises loving kindness, judgment, and righteousness in the earth, for in these things I delight, saith the Lord. Very powerful words. This is what the Lord delights in.
Amen.
One, that you may know him. Hallelujah. And that he exercises loving kindness. We know a God of love. I don't know a God that is not the God of love. and of wisdom. That is my God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And he shows us his wisdom. Hallelujah. And we are to delight also in his judgments, in his righteousness. Hallelujah. It says, through Christ, acts of redemption, we receive his righteousness, but it's because of what Christ had done. We receive it, the righteousness of God, when we walk righteous before our God. We are doing that which is pleasing God, and we're walking in order that God has ordained for us. You want to know what it means walking in the Spirit? You walk in charity, and you walk in the faith of the Lord Jesus Christ. I believe it's in Galatians 2:20 where Paul talks about the faith that he walks in, and it's the faith of the Lord Jesus Christ, the one that was crucified for him. Now let's go to verse 4. He said, I have glorified thee on the earth, and I have finished the work of redemption for us, which thou gavest me to do. God ordained him to bring forth the redemption. But it was God himself that came, glorified by obedience to the word. Now the word that he is speaking of is not just any word. It's the divine word of God.
Amen. Yep.
Hallelujah. Because Jesus Christ is the divine word of God.
Amen. Yep.
Does he not say in the beginning was the word? And the word was with God? And the word was God. Or in other words, he's divine truth.
Amen.
You ever notice when Jesus said, I am the truth? He's saying, I am the divine truth.
Amen.
Because Christ was divine.
Amen.
I am the way. And I am the truth, the way, and the life. Life only comes from God himself. But it comes to us through his love. He gives us life and through his words. That's why Jesus said in John 6:63, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. So within the word of God, there is life. When God created man, he spoke the word of life into him. He said he breathed into him, but he spoke the word of life into him. So I want you to see how powerful the word of the Lord truly is. Hallelujah. Now let's go to verse 5. Hallelujah. And now, O Father, glorify thou me with thy own self, with the glory which I had with thee before the world was. Hallelujah. He said, Lord, in his humanity did all these redemptive acts. As the human acted, the divine of the Lord drew close to one in the manner we're glorified with the Lord. Hallelujah. And this is what happens to us. The closer we draw to God and to his divine truth and to his very presence, the more he places upon our lives. But we are to walk in righteousness, or in the order of God. Righteousness is just walking in the way that God has ordained us to walk. Hallelujah. So we begin to see how powerful the word is, but you must realize the word is divine. When you open up the Bible and you look at these words, do you see them as the divine word of God?
Yes.
You should.
Amen.
Because the author of the Bible is none other than
God
himself.
That's right.
And these words were written by holy men,
yep,
who were moved by the Spirit of the Lord,
yep,
and they wrote down the divine word. Hallelujah. And this is why you must understand the word. And this is why I believe in the word of the apostles. As you read through the chapter 17 of John, you will see he said, I have given them thy word. And did we not say the word is divine truth?
Amen.
God gave them divine truth, and they knew it, and they understood it, and they received it. So when they went forth, when they spoke about Jesus, his death, burial, and resurrection, and the gospel of Christ, because the word, the divine word, was shown unto them by the Lord himself, and they received it. And this is why we walk according to their words, because they received divine truth. Now, shouldn't you and I receive divine truth?
Amen.
Amen.
It's part of, if you realize his word is truth, is divine truth, you begin to realize and you look at the word in a different way and say, Lord, reveal to me your divine truth. That's why Jesus was able to say, I am the truth. Because he was the divine truth, because he was God himself in human form. Hallelujah. Now let's go to verse 6. He said, I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou givest me out of the world. And what was the name that was manifested? Jesus. He manifested God's name.
Jesus.
And what name was manifested?
Jesus.
Jesus. And they have believed on the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Why do you think Paul later on writes, says, everything you do in word or deed, do it all in the name of Jesus? Because it was revealed unto them the name. That's why Peter said, there is salvation in no other name but the name of Jesus. So it's powerful once you understand the name, and is the very name of God. Hallelujah. I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world. Thine they were, and thou gavest them to me, and they have what? Kept thy word. You see why? They kept the divine word of God. Hallelujah. And they taught the divine word of God as it was shown and revealed to them. So it tells us, hallelujah, that they kept the word. Psalms 22 and verse 22, it says again, I will declare thy name unto my brethren. In the midst of the congregation will I praise thee. So the name was revealed to them.
Amen.
To who? At this time, the 11 apostles was revealed unto them the name. Hallelujah. And how the word that was received into them. Do you know the Bible said in the book of Peter that we're begotten of uncorruptible seed?
Amen.
The word of God. The word of God entered into our life.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So we continue to understand these things. Now they know that all things whatsoever thou hast given me are of thee. Or they knew everything was given to him from God, or came down from God. For I have given unto them thy words which thou gavest me, and they have what? Received them. So they have received divine truth, divine understanding, divine wisdom. They receive the very essence of God. And John is a man that likes to write about the very essence of God. Does he not?
Amen.
You see how much he speaks about love? The very essence of God. And that's why it is so important to understand what the Bible means about love and truth and divine love. Hallelujah. And have known surely that I came out from thee, and they have believed that thou didst send me. So when the Lord came, he came as divine truth, or the word, which is divine truth. How important is that to know? It's very important that you know. Because Jesus never lied about anything.
Amen.
Because he was divine truth.
Amen. Yeah.
He was able to show you the way because he was God. Hallelujah. And in John 1:1 it says, in the beginning was the Word. And the Word. And actually in the book of Deuteronomy 18:15, it talks about the prophet that was to come, which is our Lord Jesus Christ. And you know what he would bring? The very Word of God. God said, I will put my words in him. And what he speaks will be divine.
Amen.
So every time you look at the words of our Lord Jesus Christ, realize they are divine. They come from God.
Amen.
And they are very powerful.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Because the Bible says the word, or the divine word, is sharper than any two-edged sword. So it is powerful, the word.
Amen.
Because it's divine word, it's the divine truth of God that we have written here in his Bible.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So we must learn, as we read the scriptures, say, Lord, reveal your divine truth to me, as you did to the apostles. This is what this chapter is telling us, that he gave the word, the divine word, to the apostles. They accepted it, they received it, and guess what? They preached it. That's why you can trust in the teachings of the apostles. You go to Acts and all the other books, hallelujah, they're speaking the divine word of God that they received. Hallelujah. This is what I believe, okay? Verse 10, and all mine are thine, and thine are mine, and I am glorified in them. How? Through the preaching of the gospel. They were glorified through the word, hallelujah, that the Lord gave them. And they preached that word. And God raised them up and lifted them up in order so they could preach the divine word of God. Hallelujah. Verse 11. And I am no more in the world, but these are in the world. I come to thee, Holy Father. Keep through thine own name those whom thou hast given me, that they be one as we are one. Hallelujah. Their oneness and even their beliefs and their teachings, they all believe the same thing. It was all revealed to them, the divine truth of the word. The apostles knew the divine truth of the word. And when they taught it, the people were to receive it as the word of God. We also are to receive these words as the words of our Lord, because they are. He has inspired them and gave them to them. Hallelujah. Verse 12, it says, while I was with them in the world, I kept them in thy name. Those that thou givest me I have kept, and none of them is lost but the son of perdition, that the scripture might be fulfilled. Yes, the scripture spoke of Judas, that he would betray the Lord. Yeah. So the Lord was not able to keep him, as he kept in his word and in his love. Hallelujah. He said, now I come to thee, and these things I speak in the world, that they might have my joy fulfilled in themselves. You wonder why the apostles rejoiced every time they were persecuted? They had the joy of the Lord in them, and they had the divine word of God in their lives, and they knew what they were about to encounter. Do you know in the book of Amos, it says, I will not do anything unless I reveal it to my prophets. Hallelujah. I believe the Lord revealed all these things to them while the Lord was teaching them. He taught them how much they would suffer. He said, if they hate me, they will hate you. If they were to love me, they will love you also.
That's right.
Hallelujah. So they knew, because of the word given to them, they knew they were to suffer. They knew the Lord was to suffer also. Let's continue on. Verse 13. And now come I to thee, and these things I speak in the world, that they might have my joy fulfilled in themselves. Verse 14. I have given them thy word, or thy divine truth, and the world hath hated them that would not receive divine truth, hated those that received the divine truth of the Lord. They rejected the word of God. And these are the ones that will truly hate us, those that are opposed to the divine truth of the word, because they are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. Verse 15 is also a very powerful verse. As I pray not that thou should take them out of the world.
Amen. Yes, amen.
Hallelujah. That's why I tell you, if he didn't take them out of the world, he's not taking us out of the world. We're here to stay until the last day when the Lord puts an end to everything. Because all these prophecies that the Christ our Lord spoke happened in that generation that he was speaking to. And this is why I tell you all of this has been fulfilled, that the Lord spoke of in Matthew 21 through 25. It's been fulfilled because it's talking about, hallelujah, the very destruction of Jerusalem, the book of Revelation. Hallelujah. Now let's go to 15. I said, I pray not that thou shouldest take them out of the world, but thou shouldest keep them from evil, from the evil one. And we know that we are of God, and the whole world lieth in wickedness. Hallelujah. They understood the condition of the world, but the other thing that they knew, the only thing that would save them, is the divine truth of the gospel.
Yeah.
And that's why they preached it. Do you know it's the same thing in the day and hour that we lived?
Absolutely.
And I asked the Lord, what is your will? And he simply said, preach my gospel.
Yeah.
Because his gospel is what does the work. It's
yeah.
powerful. Hallelujah. And it explains, as you bring forth the gospel, you begin to see the love and the goodness of God. And you begin to realize the wisdom that God had. His wisdom is not like yours and mine. Who would ever thought the cross was the wisdom of God?
Yeah.
But it was.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about, God's wisdom. And these are the things we must understand, that God is wisdom. Everything he did knowing what he was. And he didn't need any help. He's the self-existing God. He needs no help from nobody, and especially us.
Yeah.
Sometimes we get in his way. But hallelujah, we know that God is able to do all things. Now let's go to verse 16. It said, they are not even of the world, even as I am not of the world. And look how he sanctifies them. In the same manner he sanctifies us, through his word, but it's through the truth.
Amen.
There are truths in the world, but they're not divine truth.
Amen.
What Christ spoke was divine truth.
Yep.
Or, you know, it comes from God himself. Hallelujah. Sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth. Or what sets us apart? What set them apart? The divine truth.
Yeah.
And their wisdom and knowledge and love they had for their Savior.
Yeah.
They knew their God was a God of love.
Mm-hmm.
And he was a God that would judge. But his judgments were always just. And our judgments also must be what?
Just.
Because we must also walk in the wisdom and the love of God, which requires us to be just in our judgments. Hallelujah. You really want to know how to please God? You walk upright and just before your God. You do that which is right and pleasing to him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We're also sanctified and washed by the word, or the divine word. That's how we continue to be washed. It's how we continue to be sanctified, by the hearing of the word. If we are to walk in faith and in charity, how does faith come?
By hearing.
By hearing and by the word of God.
Amen.
Because the word is divine.
Amen.
It is powerful.
Yes, amen.
It can change your life.
Amen.
It can turn your life completely around.
Yeah.
If you truly believe that the word of God is divine.
Yeah.
And that's why these scriptures are given to us. And we must see them in the light that God sees them, or the purpose he has brought them forth. As I told you before, I believe the whole Bible is God concerned about the very salvation and the welfare of mankind. That's why God came to redeem us.
Amen.
That's why he allows us to hear is divine truth. And Jesus is divine truth.
Amen.
And everything he spoke of was divine. Because he was that prophet that was prophesied to come. And he said he would must listen to him. Now let's go to verse 18. As thou hast sent me into the world, even so I have also sent them into the world. And why did he send them into the world? Because they receive the divine words of God. They knew them, they understood them, they received them. And then he gives them the commission to go into all the world and preach the gospel.
Amen.
To every creature. Because the word is so powerful.
Amen.
And if you can believe it, all things are possible to them that believe.
Yeah.
But in the word, the divine word, and the order. That's why our life must be in order.
Amen.
in the things of God. So nothing hinders our prayers. And we begin to realize that our prayers are powerful.
Yes.
Because God has placed his word into us.
Yeah.
And he has given us an understanding of what his will is. Many times when he spoke, he said, I'm not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance.
Amen.
And what brings us to repentance? The goodness of God, which is part of his love that comes to us.
Yeah.
If God came to us in his purity, you know what we would do? We'd either run or fall over dead.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. That's why he comes down, his love comes down to us in goodness.
Amen.
So you must understand these things in order to serve your God. Once you know your God is love and wisdom, you pray, Lord, fill me with your love. Fill me with your wisdom. Cause me to know you and understand you, to know your very divine purpose. Now let's go to verse 19. And for their sakes I sanctify myself, that they might also be sanctified through thy divine truth or through thy word.
Yes, amen.
Hebrews 10:10. By the which will we be sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. That's why Christ's sacrifice was once and for all. There is no other sacrifice. They cannot go back to sacrificing animals.
Ever.
And God will receive them.
Never.
Do you know that that's what their plan is?
Yep.
Hallelujah, but God will not receive them.
That's what he says.
It's out of the divine order of God. Christ came through the divine order of God, and he established a divine order also for us in the church. And you must know there will never, ever be another sacrifice.
No.
Never, ever.
There remaineth no more.
Hallelujah. So let's continue on. I just have a few more verses I want to read. It says, neither pray I for these alone, for them also which would believe on me, how? Through thy words.
Yeah.
And I thank the Lord that their words are written down to us.
Amen.
Their words were so strong and so divine.
Amen.
And when they were brought to us, they still have the same power and impact.
Amen.
Because they are divine.
Yes.
How they originate from God. As I told you before, everything originates from God.
Amen.
Everything we have received from God.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
So the Bible said, why do you think that you have gotten anything? Everything you have received, you received from him. Your knowledge, your understanding, your salvation, you received it from him. Hallelujah. Let's continue on. I got a few more verses to read. So we realize that this is why we believe in the apostolic word, that they all may be one as thou, Father, art in me and I in thee, that they also may be one in as that the world may believe that thou hast sent me. Hallelujah. Verse 22, and the glory which these thou gavest me, I have given them, that they may be one even as we are one. Verse 23, I in them, and thou in me, that they may be made perfect in one, and that the world may know that thou hast sent me, and has loved me, has loved them, as thou hast loved me. He says, Father, verse 24, I'm just going to read in closing the last three verses. Father, I will that they also whom thou hast given me be with me where I am. Did he not say, where I am, you shall be also?
Amen.
That they may behold my glory, which thou hast given me, for thou lovest me before the foundation of the world. The plan of God was already set before the foundation of the world. Hallelujah. And that's the coming of the Lord. O righteous Father, the world hath not known thee, but I have known you, and these have known that thou hast sent me. And I have declared unto them thy name, the name of Jesus, and will declare it, that the love wherewith that thou hast loved me may be in them, and I in them. So you know God placed his love also in them. But he also placed his word to them and revealed it to them. Hallelujah. Divine wisdom and divine love. Do you know he's placed that divine love in us?
Yeah.
I think it's in Romans 5 and verse 5 that God shed his love abroad in our hearts through the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
So you have the love of God in you.
Amen.
If you have the Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Jesus.
And you have that word in you, you also
have
the wisdom of God.
Amen.
Can we stand this evening?
Amen.
And thank the Lord.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
That we may believe.
Hallelujah.
Because they believed and accepted the very divine word of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And they have brought it to us.
Amen.
So let's lift our hands and thank him tonight.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus, I want to thank you for your word.
Lord,
how you have brought it to us. And we know it is divine. We know it is powerful. We know it brings life. Hallelujah, brings everything to us. Because your word is so powerful. It's quicker than any two-edged sword. Hallelujah, everything we have received because of your word. And we believe in your divine word. And you sanctify us, Lord, tonight through your word. Hallelujah, as you sanctify them. So that you also may send us into the world sanctified with the wisdom and the love of God in our hearts through Christ Jesus our Lord. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless you. Shine his countenance upon you, give you peace and rest. You're dismissed in his name tonight.